Dude, that girl was totally checking me out. If I made a move, there was no way I would have been rejected.
Yeah, she was hard to type, dude.
Dude, I know she wants to scare those 64.
Wait.
No! Where did my snacks go?
Shujin, my snacks have just been stolen yet again. My fellow mathletes are also going through the same thing. I don't know what I'll do about my Twizzlers and Pop-Tarts. What are we gonna do?
Oh, Egbert, you're so fat. Here, try one of these vegan, non-GMO, gluten-free, low-sodium, no-sugar, organic rice rollers.
Pathetic. You know what else is pathetic? My snacks are getting stolen.
Fine. I know exactly what to do.
Okay, genius. Enlighten us, perhaps?
We should call the myth, the legend, the god himself.
The detective.
All right, I'm on it.
I was hired to help the students find a thief. A snack thief. Apparently, junk food had been stolen frequently the past few weeks, and they needed someone to put a stop to it. I was the man for the job. I had a huge record of solving crimes, and I wasn't about to let these people down. When I got here, I was acquainted quickly with a young man named Egbert. He was the one who called me here.
Detective, our snacks are getting stolen, and we don't know who's behind it.
I know, Egbert, and I'm here to find this crook, and you're going to help me.
Really? Thank you, Detective. I won't let you down.
He was naive, but he had a good heart. We started off looking around the campus for clues. We stumbled across a pile of snow.
Wow. There sure is a lot of snow here.
That's right, Egbert. There's too much snow for someone to come in from the outside. Egbert had led me in the right direction. It was impossible for anyone to enter or exit unnoticed with this amount of snow. Thus, I realized I needed to start investigating within the school. Egbert, we need to talk to some people within campus. Direct me to some students.
Okay.
When was the last time you saw your snacks?
So, I walked back to my dorm. It was just me and my friend. We walked inside and we were just chilling out. He sat on the bed and I got a little hungry, so I walked to my snack drawer and I reached my hand inside and realized all my snacks were gone. They were probably stolen. Like, where else could they have gone? What kind of monster would have done this?
Interesting. Where did you say you lived?
King.
This led me to believe that the thief had struck places around boys' camp at the very least. I needed to find some more information.
Have you ever had your snacks stolen, miss?
Obviously. Snacks are no longer safe in this day and age from the prying hands of selfish students.
Wow, that's awful, right, Detective?
Absolute injustice. What time do you figure your snacks were stolen?
I suspect they were stolen during chapel.
So the thief struck both girls and boys intended to pilfer during mandatory events. This was all extremely interesting.
Why are you talking to yourself?
Huh? Oh. It makes me look cool and it helps me organize my thoughts, but I digress. Even still, there was more to be solved. Without hesitation, I headed over to my next interviewee. What snacks have been stolen from you?
None! For some reason, the thief doesn't take my vegan, non-GMO, gluten-free, organic, sugar-free rice rollers.
Oh, gross.
Not gross, Egbert. Important. Incredible. It seemed that whoever the thief was, they seemed to avoid healthy food. This shows that the thief cares more about taste than about health. Clearly demonstrates that the thief has a strong connection with people and is always willing to converse. Simple.
Who do you think could possibly be this snack thief?
Well, everyone who I suspect had an alibi during this time they were stolen through the chapel.
Hold on. Chapel? That couldn't be right. This guy lives in boys' camp, on the opposite side of campus from girls' camp.
Not to mention, multiple students had their snacks stolen.
This must mean that it couldn't be only one thief.
Thank you for your answers. Welcome. Egbert, I think we've gathered enough info. It's time to head back to the board.
Thank you.
Egbert, I'm getting hungry. I want some snacks. Egbert, it's been a busy day. I think we should go and get some snacks at the concession stand to boost our energy. Egbert, why is the concession stand closed?
Maybe it is closed because all the snacks were getting stolen.
This is ridiculous! There is no justice in snacks being stolen. Do you see any faculty that we can consult?
I don't see anyone. Wait, there's Coach. You can ask him about it.
Did you save me some snacks?
Yes, there are more in the locker.
Oh.
Coach, you don't leave during the half times. Why are those?
I caught those criminals red-handed. It turns out, the teachers were the ones stealing the snacks from the students the whole time. In the end, the headmaster kicked out all the teachers, and the school went back to a happy, peaceful place.
Thank you so much for your services. Detective, by the way, what's your name?
It's Detective. That's my birth name. D space Detective. I thought you knew that.
Okay then, Mr. Detective.
Hello? Detective speaking. Alright. Yeah, no problem. I'll be right there.
Every day, a student at the Orme School has something stolen from them.
Aren't you tired of getting your stuff taken away from you?
Aren't you tired of seeing multiple emails from students?
Let's stop this madness.
We can end this.
Together.
I feel